Hello， 大家好，欢迎来到大学问小学堂。职业不分贵贱，学问不分高低，快来小学堂跟我们一起徜徉知识的海洋吧。适逢今天是联合国人权日，站在巨人的肩膀才能看到更宽广的世界，听闻智者的言论能够启发更深入的思考哦。首先让我们来观看这一段致辞。
各位贵宾，各位好朋友，各位女士，各位先生，大家好。联合国大会于1948年12月10日发布世界人权宣言，1950年将每年12月10日定为人权日。世界人权宣言以人生而自由与人生而平等为理念，是历史上第一份明确列出30项基本人权的文件，也是世界上翻译语言最多的文献资料，有500多种语言版本。这显示出人权这项普世价值已被公认为实践自由、正义、安全与和平，甚至是人类社会永续发展的基石。受到世界人权宣言的启示，联合国在1966年制定了《经济、社会及文化权利国际公约》及《公民权利和政治权利国际公约》，进一步阐明并执行落实各项人权精神。该国际两公约与世界人权宣言合称国际人权法典，为国际间最重要的人权典章，奠定了国际人权法的基础。今天是再度提醒我们人类与生具有天赋人权的重要日子，任何人或公权力都不应侵犯或者剥夺他人的基本人权，应该尊重、保护并共同捍卫。美国人权斗士马丁·路德·金恩博士说过，任何地方的不公不义都威胁着所有地方的公平正义，也如同联合国秘书长安东尼奥古特雷斯曾说的，侵犯人权的行为对我们所有人都造成伤害。唯有人权被重视、被落实，和平才会存在。尊重人权是国际社会中民主国家紧密连结的基础。然而，全球局势愈发严峻，基本人权在全球各地持续遭受挑战。在世界许多地方，人权捍卫者遵循良心走上街头，要求公权力尊重及维护其公民、政治、经济、社会和文化等权利。大家都听到人权的号角响起，人人起身而行，为自己的国家未来努力。人权是联合国17项永续发展目标的核心，没有人性尊严，就无法有效地推动永续发展。要实现全球永续发展的目标，必须为所有人创造平等的机会，果断采取行动，为维护人权站出来，紧密团结，共同努力复苏并超越从前。联合国号召全球世界公民为人权挺身而出，将人权置于后疫情世界的中心，推动社会革新，打造出更具包容性、更坚韧、平等、人人享受自由、免于恐惧的国际社会。现今世界充满不安与挑战，全球问题如战争、环境变迁、 极端气候等地球资源被无止境的滥用与极度的分配不均，以及新冠病毒疫情与大自然的反扑，为人类带来许多不可预知的毁灭性灾难，加上人心腐败的利益争夺、官僚贪腐、荼毒百姓，形成各种急迫的人权议题，而动荡不安的现象直指同一个根源。联合国人权事务高级专员巴瑟莱曾说，对于饥饿、贫穷、不平等都有疫苗，如果认真看待的话，包括气候变迁与人类面对的诸多疾病也可能有疫苗，而疫苗的名字就叫做人权。巴瑟莱表示，国际社会应该利用这支人权疫苗建立更具防护力、更包容的社会，我们共同的人性根植于人权、平等、正义和自由，这些普世价值需要不断被呼吁、被看见、被实践，才能预防暴力发生，并维护世界的稳定与和平。天地有序，因果循环，人类共业，自食其果。解套必须从根本的因着手改变。因也就是人心，自私的心让人忘记人与人之间基本的尊重。没有尊重就没有人权，没有人权就没有自由、平等、民主、宪政和博爱。人权的本源就是良心，良心是万善之源，恻隐之心是道德的源头。人权以良心和爱心为基础，以恻隐之情维系群体。法国启蒙思想家卢梭认为，在每个人的灵魂深处，生来就有一种正义和道德的原则，所指的就是良心。2019年联合国大会通过订定每年4月5日为国际良心日，正式体察到良心为扭转世局的关键要素。世界自然和平总会提出国际良心日宣言，鼓励人人以慈悲、勇敢和真智慧面对国际与国家危机，积极寻求和平、和谐及多赢方案来造福地球与世人，有建立爱与和平，促进世人的福祉，是地球永续最重要的发展基石。鼓励世界公民培养心中的爱，方能在强化经济、社会、文化、心灵、科技与教育发展中得到平衡。这也是现今全球急需的心灵疫苗。在人权日这一天，我们期许所有国家、组织与个人共同保护、促进和实现人权，并以有效和创新的方法因应挑战。在追求人权的路上，我们需要坚定的信念与慈悲心，便能产生能量和勇气去面对所有关卡，共同携手并帮助彼此，持续改善自身与周遭的人权环境，以无私的良心着眼，以全人类的福祉，以人权为依归，让每一位世界公民都享有人性尊严、基本人权、生活安定与幸福，实践真自由、真平等的世界一家，促进人与人、国与国之间的永续发展。 祝福各位平安健康，祝愿全球安定和谐。
人权是与生俱来的，而且任何人都不可以侵犯的，所以我们今天将来探讨关于人权的议题哦。首先，先来欢迎今天到小学堂的来宾。
嗨，大家好，我是淑梅。
Hello， 大家好，我是明珠。
大家好，我是渔夫。
欢迎三位来宾。接下来我们要来介绍游戏规则咯。第一，我们会先由电脑选出答题者的顺序，由主持人，就是我，来说明今天的题目哦。荧幕中将会呈现四个选项，请选出最正确的选项，并且说明原因哦。答对者最高的将会获得前往天堂旅游的来回机票。话不多说，即将进行我们第一次的电脑选号。
选我。
看来今天是由渔夫拔得头筹，得到了第一个答题的机会咯。第一个题目就是，法跟税是伤害人民最重，也是最容易侵害人权的。立法者跟执法者都应该秉持良心。请问以下哪一个是违反了正当法律程序？一，为避免人民欠钱不还，最好把全部资产冻结。二，为了让人民知道第一手讯息，即使案件还在审理过程，也是可以媒体大公开。三，为了尽速结案，最好趁辩护律师到场之前进行逼供。四，以上皆是。
大家好，我是渔夫。今天是联合国世界人权日，这个被学者誉为法税228的太极门假案就有好几个重大人权迫害之处。在法这个层面，单单一个侯宽仁就有以下几点。一，违反刑事诉讼法侦查不公开，事发当时在无证据未调查的情况下，太极门被400多篇连载式的媒体报道抹黑污名化，受害者多达上万个家庭。二，违法搜索，案发的隔日有太极门弟子接受媒体访问，陈述自己在太极门身心受益的实情，在没有犯罪证据、没有人指控的情况下，随即遭到违法搜索及传讯，情节犹如白色恐怖一般，企图制造寒蝉效应。监察院调查报告指出，检察官对太极门弟子文某某、李某某二人之身体、住宅进行搜索，搜索理由牵强，未符刑事诉讼法相关规定，且逾越必要程度，嫌有侵害人权之余。三，找不到证据起诉检察官，违法押人长达4个月。四，违法冻结资产，检察官未于本于职责查明是否确系被告犯罪所得之物，即将其名下不动产悉数冻结，其强制处分嫌有违失，严重侵害人民财产权益。五，检察官询问被告时未依法通知其辩护律师到场，侵害当事人权益。在税的部分，国税局更显离谱，监察院调查税捐稽征机关就太极门税务案件有关个人综合所得税部分，仍有未善尽服实调查核定之责。
税捐单位是不是已经完成的调查证据？而且呢，刑事案件在审理中，他居然就啪就开始啊，就已经把税单开出来，这都违背了程序上的正义。老实讲，违背程序、非议正当程序所为的这程序都不应该法律上认可了。
I've studied the Taijiman tax case for close to 2 years. I've written an article about the Taijiman tax case. I don't think I've seen more abuse of the right of due process.In any situation than I have seen in the Taijiman tax case. It is not due process for the Ministry of Education to determine that Taijiman is not a cram school and for prosecutors and tax authorities to disregard that determination. It is not due process for the NTB to issue tax bills and to continue to issue tax bills based on allegations of an indictment that have been thrown out in three separate criminal trials. It is not due process to have the interagency group get together from all of the different departments of Taiwan to finally address the persecution of Tai Chi-min and agree on a process for doing that through a survey and then falsify the results of that survey. That is not due process. And it is not due process for the Taipei High Administrative Court and a Supreme Administrative Court to rule in favor in Tai Chi-min and then do what? Send it back to the same individuals and authority that issued the tax bills in the first place and collected bonuses for those tax bills. It is not due process to be caught on this treadmill of remand by the administrative courts back to the Ministry of Finance and back again, and this never-ending treadmill where individuals at the ministry or any other tax officials can reissue the same bills time and time again, and causing taxpayers time, money, and concern for decades. I think that a 20-year ordeal is a violation of human rights. Justice delayed is justice denied. And to delay justice for 20 years and to still not have it, as we're sitting here today, is in my mind a denial of justice. And the thing that perplexes and even disturbs me is the fact that that justice has been denied and delayed by just a few individuals. It is appalling to me that those few individuals could hijack an entire government.
恭喜渔夫旗开得胜。接下来我们要进行第二回合的电脑选号咯。
选我！
恭喜淑美紧接在后成为第二个答题者喽！我们的题目是：我国宪法及两公约保障人的基本人权不可侵犯，当中的宗教信仰自由是什么意思呢？一、修行圣地不可被查封或拍卖；二、在民主国家就不会发生被迫害的情形；三、收红白包的受赠人要被课税。四、宗教信仰自由主要是在保护高层官员，请选择。
太极门案是一起冤案，本无诈欺，无逃漏税捐，起因于侯宽仁检察官的滥权诬告。民国86年，道馆还几近面临封馆的命运，可是师兄姐团结一心，师父叫我们用心、用功、用忍、用和，终于迎来司法无罪的判决。太极门是师徒关系，弟子以红包表心意的赠与，在法律上赠与是不需被课税的，即使要课税，也是课赠与人，而不是课受赠人的师父。虽然透过行政救济过程中，国税局输了18次，税捐单位仍然不断重核，纳税人赢不是真赢，形成违法税单万年不死。即使提出7401份函产表的事实证据，皆无法平反国税局误导，行政法院枉法判决不撤销假税单，执行署官员更质疑执行违法拍卖本门财产。依强制执行法第53条规定，祭祀、礼拜所用之物不得为查封之对象，此为保障人民宗教信仰自由，所以太极门修行道场预定地自不得予以查封及拍卖，并且依法应予以撤销并返还。
Taiwan is nowadays one of the great democracies in the world. So how can we understand that after 14 years, a few bureaucrats are still able to harass and persecute a peaceful and honest movement that has proven its good faith in court for the last 25 years. How can we understand that less than a year ago, Taiji men saw their land and properties auctioned and confiscated by the state? Well, no country is perfect. But the problem is that when it's a so-called democratic country which starts erring on the wrong side of the tracks, when injustice occurs in a place that is supposed to be one of the good places of the world, the effect may be worse than when it occurs in an already totalitarian country. Why? Because it lowers the very standards of democracy for the entire world. It sends the message that injustice would not matter, that wherever you are, bad guys can win over good guys, and that there is no accountability in this world. A system where dishonest civil servants are allowed to continue to abuse their power without being stopped and without effective accountability needs reform. In the Taiji men case, the authority of control has found gross violations of human rights by the authorities for their wrongful handling of the case. That is already a good thing, but it has not stopped the fanatics who were at the origin of all attacks against the Taiji men. It has not put a final period to the case, because what matters to Taiji men Dizi is not the property per se. What matters the most is their right to practice their spirituality freely without being harassed, the right to teach their spirituality freely without being harassed, the possibility to spread goodness around without undue interference and without undue burdens. I make the wish that the Taiji men finally see the end of the persecution and recover its properties and land. And I make the wish that justice prevails once for all in the Taiji men case, so that all of the Dizi can now concentrate on their spiritual mission and practice without interference for the greatest good.
没错，在民主国家，面对不公义，人民可以发声及推动改革，但当真相真的被掩盖的时候，反而被容易忽略哦。恭喜淑美作者做出了正确的判断。接下来就是我们的压轴明珠啦。那我们在了解了这么多的人权，你知道破坏人权最常来自哪里吗？一、邻居；二、家人；三、政府；四、小白，请选择。
前总统马英九曾说，王侵害人权，侵害者十之八九都是政府。太极门发生在1996年12月19日，经过10年3个月审理，2007年最高法院判决太极门无罪，无欠税，无违法税捐稽征法，国税局就应该撤销违法税单。而且2010年立法院公听会，财政部公开同意两个月内终结太极门冤税案件。2012年国税局依照行政院跨部会决议所进行之公告调查结果，7401份证据全部表明尽失力是尽矣，跟2007年刑事判决结果一致，再次证实没有欠税的问题，但国税局却持续违法课税。2020年8月21日，太极门修行圣地被违法拍卖，并强行收归国有，剥夺太极门师徒的信仰宗教自由。我立中正大学财经法律学系特聘教授黄俊杰指出， 太极门是台湾人权指标案件，政府不可回避。监察院已经依职权调查太极门案，认为此案构成侵害人权，就必须依照国家人权委员会组织法进行后续处理及救济。这不是财产权而已，太极门的修行预定地被违法拍卖，涉及两公约保障的文化、信仰、宗教自由权，这是重要的人权核心价值，期盼政府能尽早处理。
During these years, we have been able to appreciate the international importance of the UN and what can be achieved with the UN bodies in the defense of human rights. Over the past 4 years at the UN, with the help of the organization present here at this conference today, we have repeatedly denounced the discrimination against minorities around the world.We have brought to the attention of the UN the discrimination of religious minorities in China, such as those suffered by the Uyghurs, the member of Falun Gong, and more particularly the dramatic case of the member of the Church of the Almighty God. Session after session of the Human Rights Council, we organized conferences, made written and oral statements, we held meetings with the state delegation, during which the victims were able to make their voice heard.In June 2021, we brought to attention to the UN Human Rights Council the case of the Taiji men and the injustice they suffer in Taiwan. At this Human Rights Council, we denounced how the tax weapon was used to harm Taiji men. In this statement, we enlightened and denounced the unscrupulous means used by the Taiwanese government in its attempt to destroy the Taiji men movement.The use of tax weapon against spiritual minorities is unfortunately common practices in many countries, including France, which finally, after a struggle to denounce this injustice practice, was condemned by the European Court of Human Rights. In September, at the 88th Human Rights Council session, we renewed our appeal for Taiji men. This time, we enlightened the confiscation of this Taiji men place of worship by the Taiwanese government.This is another form of discrimination, just as serious, because a spiritual community cannot exist without a place of worship. Today, the situation of the Taiji men can no longer be ignored in the world, and the Taiwanese government must allow the Taiji men to enjoy their property, their place of worship, and to make their contribution to world peace without worry.The UN mechanisms allow civil society to participate in the improvement of our society, and it is important to continue to speak out against the unfair treatment of Taiji men by the Taiwanese government. In 2009, Taiwan ratified the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, ICCPR, and the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights.The ICCPR guarantees fundamental rights for every citizen as well as freedom of religion or belief. The signing of the International Covenant is of paramount importance, but there is still a step to be taken to implement and respect the commitments made when the covenant was ratified. The model proposed by the United Nations is a balance between these institutions, the member state, and civil society.In these three components that ensure that the fundamental purposes established in 1945 by the Charter remain at the heart of the United Nations. Taiwan, like all other states, must find this balance with civil society and grow with it, not against it. It is, in fact, the struggle of the Taiji men that we support so that justice is done to them. So, that their contribution to a better, peaceful, and harmonious Taiwanese society is recognized. Thank you for your attention.
人权需要你我的守护。太极门案件发生在号称亚洲民主灯塔的台湾，却25年了仍未获得平反，现在甚至引起了国际间强烈的关注。台湾的民主法治简直沦为国际笑话，政府是该有所作为喽。 感谢今天三位的参与，虽然不分宣制，但仍然有参加奖哦，好事成双，金币一枚，欢迎下次再来挑战，也谢谢线上的观众朋友，大学问小学堂，我们下回见，拜拜。